Hello, in this video, we are going to cover the basics of MeshCentral, which is how to set up a computer on the website so that you can remotely manage it. We're going to take a look at how the website works in real time, and we're going to do remote desktop file and terminal. So stick around, we'll take a look at all of those topics. So once you have your website set up, the first thing you'll probably want to do is create groups of computers and then start adding some of the computers to the group. And then once you have that, you want to start managing them. So let's take a look at those steps. And the first thing I'm going to do is go onto my desktop here, where I already have a MeshCentral server installed. Now, this is my test server. It's my developer server that I use with a bunch of computers on my local network here that are connected to it. And so I'm going to go ahead and log into it. Now, once I log in, this server already has a lot of computers configured on it. But if you just start out, you will have no computers and no groups, no computer groups. So the first thing you'll need to do is create a computer group. They'll prompt you, you know, to go ahead and do that. Or you can go down at the bottom of the page here, it says add device group. You click on that and you say, for example, my home computers. You can select a type of group, and there's two. There's using the software agent, and there's also agentless. Now, agentless, this is a group of computers that will be managed with Intel AMT only. That's a topic for another video. But for now, we are going to create a group that requires the mesh agent. And so what we're going to do is install this remote agent on all the remote computers. The remote agents will connect to your MeshCentral server, and you'll be able to manage your computers. So once you click OK, the new group will show up here, and as one of the groups, of course. And then you will have the option to click Add Agent. And this is the main place where you have various options for adding a new agent. So the first thing you have to do is select the operating system. And so you have Windows, which is the common, and you have the two agents here, the 32 and 64-bit agent. You also have Linux and BSD, so this is like FreeBSD or NetBSD. And in that case, you have a command that you have to cut and paste as a root on that remote computer. And so you can click copy here, you can put it on a USB drive or something like that. And then once you run it on the remote computer, it will download and install the agent correctly. And this will actually download a script that will try to determine what type of computers you have. So for example, if you have a Raspberry Pi or an x86 or 64-bit server or something like that, then it will try to download the right agent and install it correctly. And then we have the binary installer. Here you download an agent that is specifically targeted at a specific binary, specific platform. You also have the macOS agent for the Apple devices. Now, this one is an agent that is both x86 64-bit and the Apple Silicon ARM agent. So basically, the agent does both those processors. We also have the ability to add a mobile device. So right now, it's Android only. You go in the Play Store, you download the Android agent, you scan that QR code with the agent, it will pair to your server. And by the way, there's two more uninstall options here if you want to uninstall the agent. So one thing to note is that when you download an agent, for example, the Windows agent here, this agent will be customized for your server and for that particular group inside that server. So when you download the agent here, you get a special executable that will make that remote computer connect to that group inside that server, inside your server. So if you want to add an agent to a different group, for example, my lab computers here, I would click on Add Agent here and download that agent. But if I want to add, of course, to my home computers, you click Add Agent and you download this one. But just make sure that the agents are not all the same. Depending on what agent you download, the computer will show up in a different group. Okay, so you download the agent, you run it, you follow the instructions, and the computer will pop up about 20 to 30 seconds later on the website. Now, what I can do then is click on a computer, for example, tiny one here, and I have a general tab. By the way, before I do that, if you look at the list of all devices here, you'll notice that it will tell you what state, what connectivity state this device is in. So agent here means that the agent is currently connected to the server for that machine. AMT means that if you happen to have Intel AMT, then the server is able to contact Intel AMT inside your device, and then it will tell you the powered state of the device. And so sometimes, especially if you use AMT or other things, the server can determine that the remote device is powered off, and so it will show you power off. But most of the time when the agent's not connected, it will show just nothing at all. You can filter, for example, by only online devices or only offline devices, all, and so on and so forth. So obviously, for example, if you filter by online devices only, that may be practical. So you see only who's connected right now. I'm going to click on a device, for example, Tiny One, and you can see the device information when it's been powered on. And I can, for example, one of the things I want to show you is how to change the name of the device. So if you click here, you can change the name, and this is the server-side name, so it doesn't change anything on the remote device. But you know, if you have names of, if the computers connect with very odd names, you want to change them to something more meaningful. For example, the name of a customer or something like that. You can do that here. But obviously, if you do change the name of a computer to something else, then it will, underneath, it will show you the OS name. So this is the original, the name as it appears on the remote computer, but this is the name that you'll see on the server side. And of course, if you change it back, it will remove the OS name field, because that's the same now as the server side field. Another thing I want to show you guys is that the entire website for MeshCentral is real time. So I am going to go right here and open a second browser window. And what I want to show you guys is that if I change the name of, for example, I'll go here. So I have my device here. If I change the name of my device, you'll see it's changed right there. And if I change it back, it changes immediately. So the entire website is real time. You never need to hit refresh on any of the pages. Same for the icon here. I can click on the icon of this device and change it to something else. And you'll notice that it changes on all the browser pages. Now this applies if a user is on a, you know, logged in on a different account. If he sees the same device, because you shared the device with another account, then when you change the name, you change the icon, it will also show up on the other users of MeshCentral. So another thing we want to do, obviously remote desktop the computer, one of the most important features. You click connect here, and you have remote access to this computer right there. Or I can actually, I can take a control of the computer in the back. Let's see. 15 here. I can take control of this computer, and then as you let's take a look here. As I move the window, there it goes. You can actually see this computer here being controlled as I am controlling it on the screen through MeshCentral. So that is how that works. And of course, there's plenty of other features here. You can take snapshot, you can chat, you can do special keys, you can right-click and customize your keys the way you want. There's clipboard, typing, there's settings where you can set up the resolution and so on and so forth. So there's plenty of options you can take a look at. Remote terminal, this will open a shell on the remote computer, and then of course you can dear LS or whatever. And also you can right click on the connect and say, for example, I want PowerShell, and it will open remote PowerShell on the computer. You can also have user PowerShell. This is to open, or user shell. This is to open a shell, but as the currently logged in user on the remote side. So when you click on that, whatever user is logged in on the other side, the shell will be for that user, or, you know, running as that user. So that's really cool. So don't forget, you can right click on the connect button. Hardware connect, this is for Intel AMT if you have that. And lastly, I want to cover files. You can go in files here, click C drive, and you can see all the files. I'm going to go in the temporary folder here, and I can grab, I'll grab a picture and drag and drop it on here, and uploads it. If you want to download a file, you actually just click on this file. Click, open, and it'll download the file here. It's a tiny little icon of me. There you go. If you want to download multiple files, one easy way to do is to click on two files, click zip, type, total.zip, and it will, the remote agent is going to compress the two files into one, and then you go ahead and download this file. And here I have WinRAR open, and you see the two files in the zip file. And then once you're done, you deselect these, you select the zip file, and you delete it. There it goes. So that's a great way to delete or to download multiple files or folders. You can just do it that way. Of course, I can also right-click. I can also select a file, rename it like this, or I can delete like that. So you have quite a bit of flexibility here in managing files. If you want to access files and desktop at the same time, you can click on desktop, open another tab. Now, if you hold the shift key and tap one of these tabs here, it will pop it up as another tab. So now I have two browser windows, one doing remote desktop and one doing remote files on the same remote computer. So that's a way you can transfer files while you're, taking a look at the desktop. So anyway, that was a quick view of, the really basics of MeshCentral. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you very much.